She was the queen of rocking a leopard print on the news desk in the field. He is the first KTLA anchorman to jam with the legendary band Chicago.
And I was walking down the street one day, being pushed and shoved. My feet were trying to beat the clock. Oh no, I just don't know.
He's been friends with them ever since, and us too. Our 30th anniversary celebration wouldn't be complete. Oh, it's such a nice box. There's Michele Ruiz. There's Carlos Amezcua. Eric Spillman, of course, in our newsroom as well. Hello to all. Michele, let's start with you. 30 years ago, I was unemployed at home watching a brand new show on Channel 5. What was that first day like for you?
Oh my goodness, Sam. We didn't know what we were getting into. We were just a group of people put together, and we were all kind of experimenting, and obviously the countdown started. There was the beginning of the first broadcast, and we were just figuring it out. We were excited, of course, because this was a new show. There was no local morning news show at the time, and we were the first ones, so there was excitement there, but boy, Did we not realize what was in store for us? And by the way, still rocking the leopard print.
Carlos, you actually, you had experience. You had anchored other shows before. Did you think this was like the craziest flip of a coin?
Well, for me, it was a blessing to get the phone call from Nick Van Hoogstraten to come to L.A. because that had been a goal of mine. But to think that the KTLA Morning News, in its humble beginnings, with just Barbara Beck, Mark Kriski, myself, Michele, and Eric, that it was going to become what it became, I don't think any of us had that notion. We were just hoping to stay employed. I mean, we got zero ratings for about 4 months before anybody even started to watch us. So, yeah, it was a humble beginning. But look what 30 years has done. Amazing.
It really is amazing. Eric, you tell me you had other jobs, now back in your hometown, a big job. What was that first day like?
The first program was horrible. Let's be honest. It was a terrible program, and it didn't work for quite a while. And then finally, after a few months, Mark Kriski was allowed to go to the Denny's across the street, and he cooked up pancakes and breakfast for everyone on the set and brought it over, and he did that live. And that was what gave everyone kind of permission to be themselves and to goof off. And Chuck is as good as a goofball as anyone I've met. Michele, all of us had so much fun. We had really groundbreaking segments. You know, we had a magic segment on this program, a regular magic segment with a magician. We had a fishing report. We would send the helicopter over people's backyards and see all the junk that they had. I mean, it was groundbreaking stuff.
And here's the thing that was always sort of a revelation to me, is that actually, and this took a while, obviously, people started to watch. And Carlos, did you have a sense that at some point there was a change and people were actually paying attention to the show?
Yeah, when I went to the grocery store, suddenly people were stopping me and saying, oh, I love your show, I watch you every day. And you know what's really strange is that 30 years later, and I haven't been at KTLA for several years, people still stop me and say, I watch you every morning. You're my favorite newscaster. KTLA and Carlos Amezcua are like this. We're interwoven. It's never stopped. And you know what? That's really gratifying that the viewers love us that much. And we love them.
No question about that. Michele, we have some tape of you with some, there were some big news events in the early 90s. There was the weather, the 92 earthquake, and all that, the 94 earthquake, I should say. Do you remember all that stuff?
Oh, yes. I mean, they're ingrained in my brain. Of course, here I'm covering the overpass collapse on the Interstate 10. I believe it was over the Venice Boulevard during the Northridge earthquake. This is literally within an hour and a half, two hours after the earthquake occurred. And I couldn't believe what I was seeing in front of me. An entire freeway overpass collapsed. So, yes, of course, by all means, I remember that. I certainly remember the torrential rains, the El Nino storms. You mentioned, obviously, the leopard print. We also got a lot of times I had that leopard print umbrella. You know, this is So
no one looked during breaking news than you.
The rain, the storms, the flooding, that's really what put us on the map, meaning people really noticed us, because we were the only local news in the morning where people could turn to here in Los Angeles to get updates on what was happening. So all of a sudden, national news, the network news programs at that point in time weren't as relevant. And that's really what got us, you know, a lot of notice.
Last thing, Eric, I know the answer to this question for you. It's like, what are we all doing now? Eric and I, the answer is pretty obvious. Chuck, what are you up to?
Well, I started a network with my daughter called BEONDTV, without a Y, BEOND.TV, and you can catch us all the time on OTT, on Amazon Fire, on Roku, and believe it or not, you can watch an interview that I just did with Barbara Beck on BEONDTV, so check it out. She and I reminisce about the first day as well, and it's a great conversation, and I appreciate everybody who helped me get started at KTLA and all the great times that I had there, all the behind-the-scenes people. And I tell you what, the love is very, very strong. And I appreciate, Sam, you so much, because as I mentioned in my tweets and my social posts, Sam Rubin brought LA to us because we were all from other places. And Sam really helped us kind of gel and brought the zany. And Mark Kriski, of course, I miss him. I wish he was with us celebrating. You know, we couldn't have done it without this amazing team, the great director, Ray Bruni, Joel Tater, all of them. They were just so amazing.
As it should be. Michele, you get the final word. What are you up to now?
Well, certainly it was very tough to leave you all, particularly you, Sam. I moved on to become an entrepreneur after I left broadcasting, and I'm now in my third company. I'm a woman. I'm a female tech entrepreneur. Believe that, a science-based tech company. Our clients are very large corporations in the federal government. In fact, we have a contract with the Biden administration. And basically what we do is we train and assess for unconscious bias in organizations and provide data. So there you go.
Interesting stuff. I tell you what. More catching up will happen both on camera and off camera. Eric and I,
hey,
Frank,
Sam,
and Jess.
Yes, Sam.
Go ahead.
Are they telling you to wrap up?
They are.
Yeah, ignore them. No rap. No. We got to keep talking. No rap. Forget that.
Just like it's always been. Something special is happening in minutes. Our next hour, that's just ahead. Good to see those guys.